ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
भगवत गीता आज इट इज चैप्टर 11 टेक्स्ट 16 17 विल सी हाउ मेनी वी रीड। सनेक बाहुदर वक्त नेत्रं पश्यामि त्वं सर्वतो अनंत रूपं नान्तं न माध्यं न पुनस्तवादिं पश्यामि विश्वेश्वर विश्वरूपं। ट्रांसलेशन। ओ लॉर्ड ऑफ द यूनिवर्स, ओ यूनिवर्सल फॉर्म, आई सी इन योर बॉडी मेनी मेनी आर्म्स बेलीज माउथ्स एंड आईज expanded everywhere without limit. I see you no end, no middle, no beginning. Purport by His Divine Grace Sri Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead and is unlimited. Thus, through Him, everything could be seen. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prestaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swamiti Namine नमस्ते सरस्वत देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पश्चादेशतारिणे श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवसादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। अनेक बाहुदर वक्त नेत्रं पश्यामि त्वं सर्वतो अनंत रूपम नान्तम न माध्यम न पुनस्तवादि पश्याम विश्वेश्वर विश्वरूपम। ओ लॉर्ड ऑफ द यूनिवर्स, ओ यूनिवर्सल फॉर्म, आई सी इन योर बॉडी मेनी मेनी आर्म्स बेलीज माउस आईज एक्सपेंडेड एवरीवेयर विदाउट लिमिट। आई सी इन यू नो एंड, नो मिडल एंड नो बिगिनिंग। So we have read from previous verses, Arjun desired to see Krishna's universal form. So in order to show his universal form, Krishna gave him transcendental eyes. After getting the transcendental eyes, Arjun started seeing Krishna's universal form. When he saw the universal form, he astonished after seeing. He never thought, because Arjun has a relation with Krishna as a Sakya, means friendship. So friendship means on equal level. So he did not know the greatness of Krishna, because he was in the friendship, Sakhyaras. So Sakhyaras means their behavior very similar each other. They eat in one plate, sleep one place, they joke each other. So he was thinking, Krishna may be a little bit more intelligent, a little bit more powerful than him. And Krishna was the son of his Bua, father's sisters. So in this way he was thinking. And when he got a transcendental eyes, then he saw Krishna. Therefore he astonished. He's saying, sab bismaya visto hishta roma dhananjaya. Dhananjaya means Arjun, because he accumulated wealth for his elder brother Dharmaraj Yudhishthir, therefore he called Dhananjaya. So he astonished and hishta roma, his hair on the body stand, means he is fully surprised. He never expected anything like this. So then with folded hand, Kritanjali Abhibhasat. It is described in the verse number 14. Kritanjali Abhibhasat. He with folded hand, he started speaking. So he is speaking whatever he is seeing. That is directly he is speaking. So in previous verse we have heard. Now in this verse he is describing. First, Visveshwar Viswarupam. He is addressing Krishna, Visveshwar. You are the Lord of the universe. Before he never thought he is Lord of the universe. Because people are recognized by their opulence. Therefore, opulence is important sometimes to show the opulence. Therefore, Krishna is showing opulence. So, unless you know the person's opulence, you will not able to respect him. Therefore, Bhagavatam describes also universal form of the Lord, Bhaum Leela, how he creates material world, how he maintains by his energy. Because this is very, very important for all the devotees, especially those who are beginners. They must know the greatness of Krishna. In Bible, it is described God is great. But after reading Bible, I think Lavanga will be angry with me. You cannot understand fully what is the greatness of God. But here in the Bhagavad Gita, you can see Krishna has two hands, two legs, two eyes. As soon as he showed his opulence, universal form, what Arjun seeing? Anek Bahu, you have so many arms. Vedas says, definition of God, we can understand in each word of Bhagavad Gita, from you can understand, it is described Krishna's godly quality. Here he says, Anek Bahu, you have many, many arms. And Vedas says, Eko Bahushyam, Krishna is one. Same time, he is unlimited. He was holding two hands. Immediately, as soon as Arjuna got a transcendental eye, he is seeing. Oh, he has not only two, so many hands, bellies, vakta netram. Vakta means mouth. Netram means eyes. He has unlimited eyes, Arjun. That's why Arjun is surprised. Arjun is not an ordinary person. He is very weak in the heart. And somebody can play magic on him. No, Arjun is such a personality. He is called Dhananjay. He can conquer over the wealth. He conquered over the Lord Shiva. So many demigods he defeated. He can shoot the arrow and rain start raining. Cloud, he can create the cloud. He can bring the water from the earth. So he was such a powerful person. We should not think he can be influenced. He's not an emotional person. But whatever is seeing, he's explaining here. He's explaining sometime. Those who are materialistic person, when they see the two hand of Krishna, when they see, oh, this is your God. He's your God. He has only two hands. God means unlimited. How if two hand means limit like us? But they do not know because they have no intelligence. Avajananti mammudha manusim tanum asritam. Param bhavam jananto madabhuta maheswaram. Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, those who have material vision, those who are materially bewildered, that is called mudha. Prabhupada told fools and rascals, means those who are materially bewildered. They cannot understand transcendental form of the Lord. Param bhavam, They cannot. Therefore, when they come to the temple, they see, oh, this is an idol. They worship idol two hands like a human being. Of course, man is made by image of God. So if we have two hands, God must be two hands. But our hand, is God's hand is different than our hand. He has two hands, but Arjuna started seeing millions and trillions hands, million and trillions eyes, bellies, mouths, because this is so very easy. It is not difficult to understand Krishna is God. It is very easy to understand Krishna is God. If we give attention on the words of Krishna, we can understand, oh, really he is God. He is unlimited. Pasyam tvam sarvato anantarupam. Anantarupam means unlimited form. Unlimited. This is unlimitedness of Krishna. That is called greatness of Krishna. Unless God is unlimited, he cannot be God. So many people are showing, presenting themselves as God. Please, can you ask him, can you show in universal form? I want to see your unlimited potency. But here Arjuna asked, Krishna is showing. And it's na antam na madhyam. I cannot see the end. I cannot see the middle. I cannot see. Arjuna, just like human being, whatever, human being has four defects. So those who have four defects, they cannot understand God. It's not possible. Therefore, it is said, Om Agyanam Timiran Dhasya Gyanan Jana Salakaya. You, if you want to know God, if you want to see God, you go, must go to devotee, a spiritual master. He will open your eyes. How? By torch of knowledge. Otherwise, you will see, oh, here, two hands. Sometimes we see the deity all the time. If you don't read Bhagavad Gita, go to see all the time deity, will not able to understand Krishna. We have to understand, see Krishna through the eyes of Bhagavad Gita. So when we are reading Bhagavad Gita, going to the temple, offering obeisances to deity, then when we see, if you remember Bhagavad Gita, because we have to see the Jnana Chakshusa, Jnana with knowledge of eyes, not our skin eyes. So therefore, reading Bhagavad Gita is very, very important. Very, very important. Very, very important. Krishna said, those who does not believe on this scripture, yah sastra vidhim utsijya vartante kam kartate. Your sastra vidhim utsijya. 16th chapter. Those who reject scripture, who does not give attention to the scripture, means he does not read Bhagavad Gita, he does not read Bhagavatam, vartante kam kartate. What he does, he behaves, his behavior controlled by his lust, kaam, desires. So he cannot be happy in this world and next world also. So sastra vidhanoktam, according to rules and regulations of the scripture, we must understand about God. This is very, very important. Very, very important. So, Pasyam, O Vishweshwar, and Vishwarupa. Because Vishwarupa, Vish means universal, Rupa means form. Your form is everywhere. Your form is everywhere. In the form of universe means everything is seeing. We'll read further. We'll read how Arjuna is seeing everything in Krishna's mouth. Explaining here further, Arjun saying, Kiritinam Gadinam Chakranam Cha Tejorasim Sarbato Deeptamantam Pasyami Tvam Durniriksh Samantat Deepta Anarkara Ditu Samagram. Your form is difficult to see because of its glaring effulgence. is spreading on all sides like blazing fire, or the immeasurable radiance of the sun. Yet I see this glowing from everywhere, adorned with various crowns, clubs, and discs. He's seeing hamlets, maces, discs, tejo rasim, effulgence, coming from all the sides. He is seeing like effulgence, like millions and millions of suns. Not only one sun, millions and millions. Like if he just, we cannot see directly one sun. In hot season, summer season, it's very difficult to see, especially if you go to India, you cannot look towards sun. But what about millions and millions sun if arises? What will happen? We cannot see. Then question comes, how you are seeing? How is it possible? You are telling me, shining like millions and millions suns. How are you seeing? Then answer is, Krishna has given a transcendental eyes. Because he has transcendental eyes, therefore even every shining around everywhere, everything shining, but he still is seeing due to transcendental eyes given by Krishna. This means universal form can be seen only by the mercy of Krishna. Only by mercy of Krishna. Otherwise, it is not possible. So then I'm reading our verse number 18. There is no purport. I'm explaining only verse. Tomaksharam paramam veditabhyam tamasya besvasya param nidhanam tamabhyayam saswat dharma gopta sanatanastvam purusho matome. You are the supreme primal objective. You are the ultimate resting place of all this universe. You are inexhaustible, and you are the oldest. You are the maintainer of the eternal religion, the personality of Godhead. This is my opinion. Now, Arjuna's opinion must be accepted, because Arjuna, with transcendental eyes, seeing everything directly. Therefore, sanatanastvam purusho matome. Mato means my opinion. What is your opinion? You are the sanatan, eternal. You does not take birth. Krishna says, I am the origin of everything. Aham sarvasya prabhavo. Matta sarva pravartate. Iti matva bhajante maam buddha bhava samanate. I am the source of everything coming from me. And Arjuna is seeing how is everything, whatever Krishna said, told before, he is seeing. Sanatana, you are eternal. And Paramam means you are the supreme person. No one superior than Krishna. Mata partaram nanat kintit asti dhananjaya. Krishna says also, no one superior than me. It is not possible. A great example in Srimad Bhagavatam, when Arjuna became Yudhishthira Maharaj became emperor, then there was Agra Puja before starting Rajasu Yajna. Agra Puja means who supreme, most famous person, most powerful person, most beautiful person, most knowledgeable person should be worshipped. Most famous person. All the people were there. And there was so much discussion. So much discussion going on. Now four Kumaras should be worshipped. Nara should be worshipped. There was so many personality. Bhim, Pitama should be worshipped. Then Sahadev, he stood immediately. He started openly declaring, in this assembly, only worshipable person is one person, one personality, that is Krishna. Nobody can compare with him. So many Nath Sahadev, so many people's opinion, so many learned scholars' opinion, this Sahadev was the son of Jarasandha. He was a king, not the brother of Pandava. So many very, very advanced devotees' opinion like this. Does not matter, either this Sahadev or the son of Jarasandha. So, son of Jarasandha, Sahadev, he declared, Krishna is the supreme person in this assembly. He should be worshipped. No one can compare any quality with Krishna. Then Bhishma Pitamah immediately accepted this proposal. He stand. Immediately stand. All the people, even great Vyasadeva was there, Sukadeva Goswami was there, all the Rajarshis were there. Everybody accepted Krishna is a supreme person. Except one person, Shishupal. Shishupal, he has envious nature. He was envious of Krishna since childhood. Only he opposed. Only Shishupal. Shishupal opposed. Otherwise,
I think we have lost Prabhuji. He will sign in again. He might have touched something. Maybe we can do a kirtan. Soni Mataji, can you do a kirtan? Or Lavanga Prabhuji, as we wait for Prabhuji to reconnect. Kindly unmute Lavanga Prabhuji and let's do one kirtan.
Yes. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare.
It is appearing in screen. This meeting is being recorded.
Yes, Prabhuji, I'm recording it.
Okay, thank you. So, Shishupal again, but no one superior than Krishna. Krishna immediately released his Sudarshan chakra and killed Shishupal. He is supreme person. Nobody raised the voice when Shishupal was killed. Everyone become very happy. And in front of everyone, Shishupal's soul enter into the body of Krishna. That is Krishna. He is supreme everywhere. Even forget his scripture. Even if we study the character of Krishna, behavior of Krishna, quality of Krishna, we can understand, you cannot compare anyone. He is supreme personality of Godhead. Arjun saw this, therefore explaining, Tvam Abhayam Saswara Dharma Gopta. You are the supreme Dharma Gopta, maintainer of eternal religion. You maintain religion. You are the father of religion. You are the father of religion. Because dharmastu sakshat bhagavat pranitam. Whatever Krishna says, that is called religion. That is definition of dharma. Just like whatever president says, that is become the law of a country. So therefore, you are saswat dharma gopta. You are inexhaustible. And best word he used, Tomasya Biswacha Param Nidhanam. You give the shelter, all the universe is resting in you. he saw all the universe is resting. Without Krishna, there is no existence. Without Krishna, there is no existence. Krishna is holding everything by his different potency. Parasya sakti vividhaiva sruyate swabhavaki gyan bal kriyacha. Krishna has unlimited energy. One energy acting this way, other energy acting this way, this energy and swabhavaki means naturally, automatically is working. He is Krishna, he is, that's why he is God. Otherwise, how can be God? Krishna is eating the mud, but his energy is maintaining everywhere, everyone. Everybody is maintained by Eko Nityo Nityanam Chetanas Chetananam Eko Bahunam Yo Vidudhatut Kaman. Vedaj said Nityo Nityanam. Krishna is one singular eternal. And Nityanam, living entity are plural eternal. So many, unlimited. What is different? One singular eternal Krishna is maintaining everyone, providing the necessity of everybody. Everywhere he is there. Andantarastha Paramanu Chayantarastham Govindam Adipurusamtam. He is every item. Just see Krishna. He is every item is there. He knows everything, past, present, and future. Vedam Samatitan Bhartaman Charjun. He knows past, present, and future, everything. So, Tvam Aksharam Paramam Veditabhyam. You are Akshar, infallible. Krishna does not fall from his position. It's not possible. Even Brahma can fall down from his position. All the demigods can fall down. But Krishna never, you'll never see. Anywhere is Krishna. Even eating mud, he still is God. He's running away from the battlefield, he's God. He's drinking, he's stealing the butter, he's still his God. Just see Krishna. Only those who are devotee, they can understand, they can appreciate. They need a devotion. Other without devotion, it's not possible. It's not possible without devotional service, somebody can appreciate quality of Krishna. It's not possible. Even, okay, if you have relationship with somebody, then you can understand. Just like her wife understand activities of husband. Husband understand wife activities of wife. Same thing, children, everywhere, because you have relation. Similarly, if you have relation with Krishna through devotional service, then we can appreciate Krishna's quality. How Krishna is merciful, providing everything. Everyone's necessity, everything. That is the mercy. Parth Prabhu, I can go on. I can stop for question and answer. What do you think? Time is 40 minutes. It's past.
Hare Krishna. I can
verse more?
Yes, you please continue one verse if possible.
Yeah, possible. No. Anadima dhyantam ananta viryam. अनंत बाहुम ससूर्य नेत्रम पश्यामि त्वाम दीप्त हुतास वक्तम स्वतेजसा विश्वेदम तपंतम. अनुवाद ट्रांसलेटर ट्रांसलेशन माता जी कैन यू रीड ट्रांसलेशन यू हैव भगवद गीता
यस प्रभुजी
वर्स नंबर 9
विद यू ट्रांसलेशन बाय श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय. यू आर विदाउट ओरिजिन मिडिल और एंड. Your glory is unlimited. You have numberless arms, and the sun and the moon are your eyes. I see you with blazing fire coming forth from your mouth, burning this entire universe by your own radiance. Hare Krishna.
Purport.
Purport by Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. There is no limit to the extent of six opulences of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Here and in many other places, there is repetition, but according to the scriptures, repetition of the glories of Krishna is not a literally weakness. it is said that at the time of bewilderment or wonder or of great ecstasy, statements are repeated over and over. This is not a flaw. Hare Krishna.
So, thank you, Mataji. Now, Arjuna again. Anadim madhyantam anantabiryam. You are anadi. Means you are beginningless, no beginning. In beginning of Srimad Bhagavatam, when Bhagavatam starts, there is mention, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. I am offering obeisance unto the lotus feet of Pita Vasudev, who is God. So how is Vasudev, son of Vasudev, is God? How is the son of Vasudev is God? Then immediately it is described, Janamadyas Yatah Annoyat. He is the cause of creation, maintenance, and annihilation. So creation begins from him. Therefore, he is origin of everything. He is origin of Brahma. He is origin of Lord Shiva. He is origin of everything. No one is origin of him. It is not somebody created him. Nobody created Krishna. Krishna created everyone. Same thing Arjuna realizing here. You are Ananta. There is so many Ananta, such Surya, Netram. He is not seeing one sun. He is seeing so many moons, so many suns like eyes of Krishna. And everything he is seeing very nicely. And swatejasa viswam idam viswam tapantam. This universe is heating because of the sun and moon. So many, not one. Swatejasa. Because of your radiance, because Krishna is the source of all the Brahma Jyoti. We understand this is meaning here. Brahma Jyoti is coming from the Krishna's body. Bodily effulgence of Krishna is called Brahma Jyoti. And this Brahma Jyoti is cause of the sun sign of cause of the sign of moon, sun, stars, whatever. This is because of Brahma Jyoti. So all the effulgence coming from the body of Krishna. Only from the body of Krishna, all the effulgence. So here, Prabhupada commented very nicely. Here, so many words are repeated by Arjuna. Again and again. Prabhupada telling here, quoting the words from the Purana, from the scriptures, there is no fault. There is no fault because in wonder, in ecstasy, when we come in ecstasy ourselves in ordinary dealing, when we become very happy, when we surprised, sometimes we repeat the word. So Krishna, Arjuna is repeating again and again few words. So we should not think he is committing mistake. It happens. This is natural. It happens. It is natural. See, in this way, Krishna's opulence is unlimited. Aishwaryasya, Samagrasya, Viryasya, Yashasastriya. These are the six opulences of Krishna. Prabhupada commented same thing. This opulence has no limit. Has unlimited. That is the definition of God. So here each verse is showing Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead. Arjuna practically is saying. Therefore, in